for coming out on a Wednesday night, and I hope you enjoy the music. Thank you. About 25 years ago, I was driving in my car, Houston, Texas, on my way to a country gig, and listening to the radio, a classical station. And so while I was driving, all of a sudden, Olivier Messiaen's piece, Et Expecto Resurrectorum Mortuorum, and I Await the Resurrection of the Dead, came on the radio. It was a piece for brass orchestra, brass and percussion. And that affected me so much that I had to pull over to the side of the road and be late to my country gig and explain to all my friends in the band why I was, what I was listening to and why I had to pull over by the side of the road. I guess I should have just made up an excuse and lied. But, so anyway, ever since I first heard this piece of music, I'd wanted to play it, to learn it. And with the kind of hubris that I had, maybe the hubris of relative youth, I thought, oh, no problem, well, I'll just get the music and figure it out. You know, all, you know, 20, 30 horns and whatever. And so needless to say, it didn't quite happen. But that idea had stuck with me for quite a while. And then about 10 years ago, I was in Italy and spending some time with the composer Alcorn and listening to the Italian composer Giacinto Scelsi. And so when I got home, I thought, well, I'm gonna do something with this. I don't know how much of this piece I could do, but I'll do something. So I figured the piece out, at least as much as I could play, which was the first three notes. So I wrote a piece that incorporates those first three notes of Messiaen's piece, and it's entitled, And I Await the Resurrection, the Pedal Steel Guitar. Astropiet Solo. Astropiet Solo, the Argentinian Nuevo Tango composer. I first saw him 27 years ago when he and his quintet performed in Houston, Texas. And his music is so powerful. And I had heard his records and I thought, wow, this is really, really wonderful. But seeing him live made a deep and lasting impression on me. And I'd always wanted to record his music solo, which was perhaps another aspect of my rather youthful hubris way back then. So Piazzolla, and I did record an album of his about 3 years ago. So Piazzolla, when his father died, he went into his music room and came out a half an hour later with a piece that he had written titled Adios Nonino. Nonino in Italian means grandfather, and that was his elegy for his father. So 10 years ago, or 2007, in June 2007, my husband and I traveled down to Buenos Aires, Argentina. And I wanted to kind of get a feel for Piazzolla's music and perhaps maybe find another way to approach his music that was maybe spoke to something that maybe I could do. And so we got off the plane. It was late at night. We checked into our apartment. And I did the thing that any normal red-blooded American would do after checking into an apartment late at night in a foreign country. Went to an internet cafe and checked my email. One of the emails was from my brother, and it informed me that my father had just died. Not only had he died, but he had died 2 months earlier, and no one had told me, which is another long story. So I wandered around that part of Buenos Aires, just sort of in shock, and it was dark and it was raining. And I don't remember too much more about that evening, that night. The next day, my husband and I went walking down Calle Florida, which is a long pedestrian street in Buenos Aires, and it has lots of street musicians and human statues and people selling things and that sort of thing. And there was an old man sitting by the side of the building with a bandoneon, the Argentinian tango accordion, button accordion. And he had a bottle of mate with him. And so my husband asked if he could take his picture. And he said, certainly. So he told me to put my ear down to the bellows. And this is the tune that he played.
Thank you.
very much, and thank you for coming out this evening, but don't go away. And I must say, this is coming from Baltimore, Maryland, home of all those characters on The Wire. It's such a thrill to be here in New Zealand, where none of them are here, for one, hopefully. I've been here for, it'll be 2 weeks total. And my husband and I were on the South Island, and we played. And now we're here in Wellington, and it's such a wonderful culture here, a wonderful geography, incredible people, phenomenal musicians, and the food along Cuba Street and in this area is incredible. So thanks again for coming, and please don't go away because there's more. And see you in a few minutes. Thanks.